It will damage our eyes.
It will damage our eyes.
Reason. So, the safety precaution which we have to take care while burning of magnesium is, understanding? So, the burning of magnesium ribbon is harmful to the eyes. That is why the magnesium ribbon should be burned by keeping it as far as possible from the eyes. Because the dazzling, a very bright white light gives given out in this during this reaction, which is dangerous to our eyes. Understand? So now, to perform this activity, how we can do this activity? The reaction involved in this burning of magnesium reaction is, how we can do means, we have to take a 2 cm long magnesium ribbon and clean it by. Immediately what we have to do? Directly we will burn or we have to clean it?
We have to clean it by.
We have to clean.
Rub it with the sandpaper, sir. By rubbing it with the sandpaper.
We have to clean it with sandpaper. Why?
Because corrosion takes place because of the action of carbon dioxide and oxygen.
Magnesium.
Carbon dioxide and
oxygen. Yeah.
Magnesium oxide.
Magnesium
oxide will form.
Magnesium oxide as well as magnesium carbonate.
Carbonate.
Yeah, that is why. Magnesium carbonate will form. So that to remove that, we should have. Understand? So the first thing. So what we have to do means we have to take 2 cm long. I will show you the diagrams also. You have to draw the same way. We have to take 2 cm long.
Sir, now what head?
Nothing
we should
just
keep
saying
sir.
The activity, how to do this activity, I am saying. Understand? So for this only nothing. So take we have to take 2 cm long magnesium ribbon and we have to clean it by rubbing its surface with a sandpaper to remove a protective layer of magnesium oxide as well as magnesium carbonate, which is formed by reacting with the substances of atmosphere. That is only we is known as called as what? Corrosion. So now, hold
sir, can you turn on your video, sir? Can you turn on it?
Oh, sorry. I have not noticed it, really. Oh, okay. So that is only called as what? Oh, that is why Pranita is saying, I have not able to see. Okay. So now, hold this magnesium ribbon with a pair of tongs. Do you know pair of tongs in our kitchen your mother is using, correct? For holding the...
Yes, sir.
So we are with, the, yes, sir. With the help of the pair of tongs at one end and heat it other end over a burner. How many of you know Bunsen burner?
Yes, sir.
Yes, with the help of that, we have to heat it.
Now, it's in laboratory.
Yes. The magnesium ribbon starts burning. It won't catch because magnesium is having a ignition temperature a little bit more. Class 8, I have taught you. For combustion, 3 things is required. One is combustible substance. Next one is ignition temperature. Next one is oxygen. Combustion
oxygen.
Supporter. Have you remembered?
Oxygen.
Yes.
Yes,
so this magnesium ribbon is having little bit more ignition temperature. Means we have to little bit heat more time to catch the fire. Once it will catch the fire, it will burn with a dazzling white flame. So the magnesium ribbon starts burning with a dazzling white flame. Hold the burner, understanding this burning magnesium ribbon over a watch glass. What is the meaning of watch glass? Some kind of curved balls will be. Have you noticed it? In our lab, you may see. Yes or no? Watch glass. Like a lens, you can take as a gauze. How many of you know this glass? Glass, you know, which is having a curved shape.
Concave lens.
What am I?
Like ash glass.
Yeah. Ash tub, you know, those who are smoking, they are having ash tub. The same way. Watch glass, this is called as. So we have to take watch glass. Why we should take watch glass means, It will burn and it will form a magnesium powder, magnesium oxide powder. As I told you, which is in which color? What is the color of that?
White color.
White color.
Yes. White color powder. So that
white powder.
We have to collect that in a watch glass. So hold this burning magnesium ribbon over a watch glass so that the magnesium oxide powder being formed and collecting in the watch glass. Understand? So that is only called as burning of magnesium and the example of chemical reaction. So it is not that chemical reactions can be carried out only in science laboratory. Don't think, sir, said that it is only, sir, you have to go laboratory and all. If you'll say, large number of chemical reactions keep on occurring in our daily life. Can anybody say, you said, sir, you have to go chemical laboratory, burn with magnesium ribbon and get the magnesium oxide powder, which is need to collect in watch glass and all. So now, is it only the chemical reactions are taking place in the laboratory, or else in everywhere?
Burning of paper.
Everywhere the reactions are taking place. So why it is taking place and where it is taking place? Examples, anybody in our daily life.
It's a burning of paper.
What?
Burning of paper.
Burning of paper, that is all Venda. Like lower classes, you don't say. I'm asking natural. Don't go for lab again. Burning, understanding, doing this, that, and all Venda. What you have learned, what kind of changes you are occurring in your daily life? The large number of chemical reactions are keep on occurring in our daily life. So what is that? Have you noticed it? Suppose if you left the, yes, rusting and all, yes, Varshini. If you left the milk in our kitchen somewhere, not heating, normally you left it, the milk will turn into sour. Have you noticed it?
Yes, sir.
So, souring of milk, first thing, because daily morning we'll start with the coffee or tea or milk. That is why I'm saying.
Sir, cooking of egg.
Yeah. Souring of milk.
Sir.
Now only he is speaking. Very good. So, what is souring of milk? Ma, not formation of curd, I'm saying. What is this? Souring of milk. When? When we left at room temperature during summer. Have you noticed it? We left at room temperature. Room temperature during where? During when?
During summer.
Summer. You can see that even our Pudukkottai region, because of more the hot temperature, if we'll keep that understanding, if you keep the milk even after boiling, also if you keep it for preparation of curd, few times curd won't form properly. Have you noticed it?
Yes,
it will spoil because of more temperature and atmospheric temperature and all. So that is only souring of milk, as well as next formation of curd from
photosynthesis.
Yes. Formation of curd is a chemical change or physical change? Formation of curd.
Chemical change.
Curd from where? From water?
From milk.
So is also another example of chemical change. As well as if you take
formation of paneer.
How many of you are sustaining without eating food or with eating food?
With eating food.
Means what? Eating food means how it is coming? Cooking of food. Correct or not?
Yes. Sir, cooking of food is a chemical change, sir.
Yes. Can you bring it back? Cooking of food.
Sir,
yes,
sir.
Chemical
okay, sir.
Next. Main thing is happening. After cooking food, what will happen? What will happen?
Digestion.
We will eat.
Digestion.
Digestion of food in our body. Very good. Digestion. Digestion of food. Not only in our body, any living organism. Digestion of food in our body. Like as well as we are doing some process called as inhaling and exhaling.
Respiration.
Process of respiration. Understand? Next, fermentation of grapes. Alcohol preparation. Have you know that? Alcohol preparation. As well, even though formation of curd is also called as fermentation only. Understand? Fermentation. So what is the meaning of fermentation means? We will take all the raw materials in a big container. You may watch in few movies. They will dump everything, grape juice and all other chemicals and all together, and they will close the container by adding the, understanding, some bacteria, fungus and all. So they will start eating, drinking that, and continuously they will produce a thick substance that is only called as even formation of curd also from the milk. Is it correct or not?
Lactobacillus.
As we know that all the alcohols prepared with the help of grape juice. Is it correct or not?
Yes, sir.
So store the grape juice for a long period of time, then because with the help of some organisms, like microorganisms, it is used to form a thick, high viscous
wine.
That is only called as fermentation process.
Fermentation of
grapes is also example of what? Chemical reaction, as well as rusting of iron when we expose to the humid atmosphere. Means atmosphere must contain moisture as well as oxygen. Next, burning of fuels is an example of chemical change. Next, burning of wax, burning of LPG, as well as ripening of fruits. Have you noticed it? By applying the ethane substance, ethane is a chemical substance, easily we can ripening the fruits. Have you noticed it?
Yes,
sir. No. By chemical spraying,
yes,
we can convert the raw fruits also into ripening fruits. Is it correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, as well as even the plant itself, naturally also the fruit will turns into ripening of fruits. Is it a chemical change or physical change?
Chemical change, sir.
Chemical change.
Ripening of fruits is a chemical change or physical change?
Chemical change.
So, this all understanding, chemical changes which involve, what they are involving. These all the things are involving what? I said so many now, correct? These all are involving what? Which involve?
Oxygen. Chemical changes.
Chemical reactions.
Our chapter. Understanding. So all these cases, the nature and identify of initial substances changes because of the chemical reaction which takes place in it. Whatever the initial substances are present, they are having completely different properties with the new substances. That is why we can say it is chemical reactions. So here, immediately if you study this, immediately one question should rise in our brain. How do we know that a chemical reaction has takes place? How? The question. Answer my question.
When the substance converts into another, leaving its...
Yes. So now, leaving its
previous...
It's not tested. Varshini, are you understand question? Are you understanding my question?
Reactants do not have any properties resembling to the reactants.
Yes, sir. That is definition which is told by me. You don't need to say my definition. I am saying that something I have given to you. Now you tell me by observing, should not touch, should not go for chemical testing and all. Basically, you have to tell me. Sir, you have told me this.
Cannot be returned to.
How we can detect
reactants and the products we should find, sir.
What?
Reactants and products we should find.
Not. That is, suppose, see, milk and curd, both are in white color only. How you can say it is milk or it is in a, either it is in a, suppose I'm showing you for a little bit far. How you can say that it is a milk or it is a curd? How you can say that it is a soured milk or it is a normal milk? We cannot say correct unless until we taste it.
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? That is what I must. Yes, so here, after learning this many examples, every mind should say that. Understand how we can tell how these chemical reactions are takes place. Understand how do we come to know? That is the question. Understanding how do we come to know that the chemical reaction has takes place or not? So for that is only called as characteristics of chemical reaction. If you know the characters, then easily you can identify either it is a chemical change or physical change. Is it correct or not? Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So that is only our next concept. So the next concept which we are going to study is, understand, characteristics of chemical reactions. Yes? Now, so whenever I have given some reaction, either it is a chemical reaction or physical reaction, how we can define means, we are having totally five kind of characteristics of chemical reaction. If we'll observe any one or two or five, anything, then we can say that, understand, it is a chemical reaction. So the important characteristics of these chemical reactions are totally how many, Amma?
Five.
So now here, what is going to happen in chemical reaction? So as we know that in chemical reaction, the substances known as reactants, are converted into products. New substances called as products. So this is called as basic chemical reaction. So here, the conversion of reactants into products in a chemical reaction is often accompanied by some features which can be observed very, very easily. Understand? So these easily observable features are changes, we can call it. Features are changes. when these reactants are converting into products, we can observe some understanding features or changes which takes place as a result of chemical reaction. Understand why these changes are taking place? Because of
chemical reaction.
That is only known as characteristics of what we used to call characteristics of
chemical reactions.
Chemical reaction.
Easily observable features which takes place as a result of chemical reactions is only known as characteristics of chemical reactions. So the important characteristics of chemical reactions are totally fine. Now for today's class, I will say that only names. From tomorrow, we'll continue that. Understand? So as we comes to know here, understand? So what is the first characteristics of chemical reaction means? Evolution of gas. Most of the chemical reactions, gas will form. Evolution of gas. What is the first one? Evolution of gas. Next, second one.
Yes.
Is formation of precipitate, means some insoluble substance will form in a chemical reaction in a test tube. That is only called as
formation of precipitate.
I will say what is precipitate and what is the color, everything. Color is not same, it is called different. Precipitate. Understanding number? P-R-E-C-I-P-I-P-I-T-A-T. Precipitate. Understand? Next, third one. Change in color. What is the third one?
Change in color.
Next, fourth one. Change in temperature. What we used to call?
Change in temperature.
And the last one.
Last one
is called as change in state. What is the meaning of change in state? Changing Andhra to Telangana or Tamil Nadu?
Solid liquid gas.
Change in state means don't say that going to Andhra to Telangana, Telangana to Andhra like that. Understand? Change in state means changing into solid to liquid to gas. Understand? Andhra state ways to go. That is. So these are the five characteristics of chemical reactions, and each and every chemical reaction we will study in the from the next class. Understanding, Amma? So today's class, anybody is having any doubt?
No, sir.
Now you have to write the definition and these characteristics also. So observe, any one of these general characteristics, any one of, not only all, every reaction cannot take place all these five. Understand? So any one of these general characteristics can tell us whether the chemical reaction has takes place or not. So for example, if we take, if I'm mixing two substances, if gas is evolved, I am mixing two substances. If gas is evolved, then we can say that what? It is a what?
Evolution of gas.
It is a product of chemical.
Hello, gas. I'm mixing two substances. Gas is evolved.
Product.
So say that it is a what?
Then a product of chemical.
The product is formed. Chemical reaction.
I am asking chemical reaction takes place or not. That is what I'm asking. Products and all went up. If I mix any two substances, yes. I'm observing that some fumes are coming. That some smoke or something is coming out. Then I can say that it is a what?
Chemical reaction.
Bubbles will form. Have you noticed it? Bubbles. Brak, like that sound we used to notice.
Yes, sir.
That is also indicate what? Evolution of gas. Means in the sense of chemical reaction will take place or not.
Yes, sir. It will take place.
So, the like that any one of these general characteristics can tell us whether the given reaction, chemical reaction has takes place or not. So, from the next class, we will give examples to show all the characteristics of chemical reactions one by one. Now you write what is characteristics of chemical reaction. Right. The easily observable. All of you understood? How many of you understood? Please give me a reaction. I'll clear any doubts in Ryan today. Arya? Roshan?
Very
perfectly learned. Understanding. There is no going fast and going slow. All must have same potential. So maintain that and try to overcome. That's all. Definitely we will overcross everybody. If you are really focusing, if you are really understand. That's all. Right. The easily observable features also used to call as what? Changes.
changes.
The easily observable features, bracket you can keep changes, which takes place as a result of, which takes place as a result of, result of what, Roshan? Result of what?
Chemical reaction.
Jesse, one from first, right. The easily observable features. Easily observable features. Bracket you can write changes. Which takes place as a result of, which takes place as a result of chemical reactions. Chemical reactions are known as, are known as characteristics of chemical reactions. Characteristics of chemical reactions. Then keep heading.
So which place is a result of?
Result of chemical reactions. Result of chemical reactions are known as characteristics of chemical reactions. Full stop. Next, keep heading. The important characteristics of chemical reactions are, exam, see, exam presentation skill be, presentation skill should be must. That is what I am saying. Directly you cannot write characteristics of chemical reactions means this five. You have to keep heading. The important characteristics of chemical reactions are, the important characteristics of chemical reactions are, colon you have to keep, then you write this five. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, right. After that, you write this five. Varshini, any doubt, Varshini?
Sir, today, what is the first class in school's timetable, sir?
I think
They didn't send any timetable, sir. What we should do, sir? Timing?
Online class or offline class?